Hand and finger injuries are among the most common type of personal injury events we see in our workplace. With all their utility and frequency of use, our hands face a much greater probability of injury. This video is about hand injury prevention, hazard reduction through the use of proper PPE, and a reminder to always wear your gloves. However, we would be remiss not to first acknowledge that any scrape, spill, pinch, burn, or strike to our mitts means our hands were already within the line of fire. Be careful around rotating equipment and watch for pinch points and sharp edges. To prevent hand injuries completely is to not have our hands in the line of fire, or to eliminate the hazard altogether. While we should always consider engineered controls such as guards, proximity devices, emergency stops, and ergonomic tools, and always ensure we have our administrative controls in place in the form of JSAs, FLHAs, warning signs, etc., there will be times where we transition down the hierarchy of controls to rely on the use of PPE to mitigate the potential hazard where other controls are not feasible or sufficient. We often deal with chemicals, use hand and power tools, repeat particular motions, and manually handle sharp edges. Our hands are sensitive to vibration, temperature extremes, and feel the impact from slips and trips. At SMJV, we provide all personnel with industry-leading ANSI Cut Level 5 gloves that also provide impact and puncture-resistant qualities. Always using hand protection ensures we've given our hands the advantage required to sustain their effectiveness and minimize the severity of injury threats.
And that's why here at SMJV, we strive to protect our most valuable assets, our managers. workers. The most valuable assets to our pipeline projects are, of course, our workers. 28% of all recordable injuries are to the hands. So that's why we're stepping it up to industry-leading ANSI Cut Level 5 gloves on all of our work sites. But what do these gloves really do? Well, today, we're here to find out. We devised a series of tests to see just what your hands can handle and what happens when we have just a little more protection. Let's get into a little of what would happen when setting the stakes for a silt fence. A 5-pound sledge dropped from 4 feet, or about 48 inches, with only a quarter inch of give when it lands, exerts over 960 pounds of force. Let's see what that does to our hand over here. With impact resistance gloves, we can drop that force by increasing the amount of give our surface has. Each of these gel rubber impact points increase our give point by a quarter inch, which reduces our force from the sledgehammer to 480 pounds. It crushes the force in half, which is what the sledgehammer is not gonna do to your hand. Let's watch. Let's break some fingers. Oh! Well, if you can see, the finger looks like it's in two pieces, and the bone that was there is now this way instead of this way, and the knuckle here is ripped open and I can see the bone, which is gross. That doesn't look fun. Let's try that again, but this time with gloves. Look. Direct hit. Let's take a look, shall we? As you can see, the bones in the hand with the glove are fine. There might be a little bit of bruising. You can kind of see a nick there, but everything is intact. It'll probably hurt. It's okay. The other hand, not so much. This bone is bent completely in half, and it's actually cracked in two, and at times has come through the skin in a quite nauseating way. This hand, destroyed. Take a look at this next scenario, with a utility knife hooked to this scary looking thing. Slipping off of a surface or a box you're trying to open can redirect the knife at up to amazing speeds. A pitcher for pro baseball teams can swing their arm at 160 kilometers an hour. In this scenario, we're just gonna swing the box knife at 18 kilometers an hour, with a 5-pound arm for momentum. Let's see what happens to these little fingers. Okay, the first thing that you can see here is that the third finger is basically got sliced in half. In fact, there's a little bone segment sticking there. So that knife, boom, came right into there. You go to the second finger here, and it looks okay, but that's because the slice was so fine, it kind of actually cut just above the knuckle, and it almost went all the way to the bone. And because third time's the charm, if we look at that pointer finger, same thing. This thing sliced halfway through that finger without a glove. So these three fingers, you're gonna be feeling that for a long time. Actually, you probably won't feel it. Now, let's try it with the glove. Okay, so when we take a look at this glove, you can see that the knife has sliced through the first layer, but only the first layer. What could have been a really bad injury right across the tendon got stopped by that glove, so you could still use that finger. And the knife did come to a rest in the second finger, but it didn't actually go through the glove there. So if I carefully move this, there we go, there we are. So at the end of the day, even though this got a slice here and there's a little chunk out there, this glove prevented a major injury from happening. Now there are all sorts of scenarios where we need the dexterity of our hands mixed with the hazards of the industry we work in. From sharp edges of pipes to falling dunnage. The dangers are out there. And this is just a small thing we can do to ensure that we're safe and that we keep all of our fingers.
Injury prevention is key. And thus, the donning of gloves is mandatory while performing work at any SMJV location. Be sure to select the most appropriate glove for your task and make sure they fit properly, and inspect their condition prior to each use, as you would with all of your personal protective equipment. Give yourself a hand and always wear your gloves.